Welcome everybody. Today I will explain about MOSFET and thyristor. What is MOSFET? How it work? What is thyristor? How it work? What is difference between them? I also have assembled two circuits in this breadboard. One using MOSFET, another using thyristor. This also I will show. Here we have a mechanical switch. If you give supply here, then by making the switch on and off, we can control the current in this. The function of this mechanical switch is done by MOSFET electronically. This is MOSFET symbol. It has three terminal. D means drain, S means source, G means gate. When we give a gate pulse like this, this MOSFET becomes on. When this is zero, here this MOSFET will be off. So this is off. From here to here, I am giving some voltage here. That is called gate pulse. So this will come on. This is on. And here again I have removed the gate pulse. So this has become off. When we give gate pulse here, only voltage applies, no current flows, because this is insulated gate. So when we give gate pulse high, we give some voltage here, it becomes on. By removing this, it becomes off. MOSFET are two types. One is N-channel, one is P-channel. This arrow difference you are seeing. I have one MOSFET with me. This is MOSFET IRFZ44N. This circuit is shown here. You are seeing this is exactly like this. But this diode and two Jena diodes are extra. These three items are inside, built in. This diode protect this MOSFET from reverse voltage. Suppose reverse voltage comes, means this is positive, this is negative. So as soon as it become positive, the diode will conduct and it will protect this MOSFET. This Jena diode protect this MOSFET gate from ESD, electrostatic discharge. Rating of this MOSFET is 55 volt 49 ampere. To use full rating, you see back side is the metal. You have to connect one aluminium thing that is called heat sink to make it cool. Now we come to thyristor. It has three terminal. Anode, cathode, gate. When we apply a gate pulse, this thyristor becomes on. A current flows like this. When we apply a gate pulse here, no current flows here because it is insulated. But here, gate current flows like this. But difference between this and this is, if you remove the gate pulse, this thyristor will not become off. To make it off, you have to make the current zero. Here I have shown. When you give a gate pulse here, thyristor becomes on. When we remove the gate pulse, it remains on. and it will become up when IR becomes 0. IR is this. So we cannot make thyristor off using gate bulbs. This is circuit inside of this thyristor working. This is NPN transistor. This is PNP transistor. When we give a gate pulse here, base current flows and this transistor becomes on. As soon as this transistor becomes on, current flows like this. So in this base also current will flow. When this current flows, this also becomes on. As soon as this becomes on, current flow like this. Now gate is not required. Gate current here will be supplied by this base current. So this gate latch. I have a thyristor with me, TYN616. Rating is 600 volt, 16 ampere. These two look similar. Here also, for using full rating, you have to connect a sink here to make it cool. This is comparison chart. This side MOSFET, this side thyristor. Now first is, in case of MOSFET, gate is insulated. See, you are seeing insulation. There is no connection here. But in case of thyristor, gate is not insulated. Because gate is insulated, no current in gate flows. It is voltage driven gate. When we connect a voltage here, electric field is generated and this becomes on. No current will flow. In this case, gate current is required. Because it is insulated, gate input impedance is high. In this case, gate input impedance is low. It requires the current. In MOSFET case, gate can be used to switch on and off both. You want to switch on, give the gate pulse. You want to switch off, remove the gate pulse or make it zero. In this case, thyristor, gate is used only to switch on. Separate arrangement is required to switch off. By using gate, you cannot switch off this. Here, if you remove gate pulse, it will come off. Here, it will not. The separate arrangement, I have shown three methods here. One is, we open the incomer itself. But this is done only during emergency. Suppose fire is there or smoke is there. Otherwise, we don't do this. Second is, we use thyristor in AC. When AC has negative voltage, or here positive, here negative, then current flowing in this will become zero or will start reducing till it becomes zero and thyristor becomes off. Here, suppose this thyristor is on and current is flowing. We have another thyristor and we divert this current this side somehow. So current in this thyristor becomes zero, so it becomes off. But there are due to your gate turn off thyristor also available. This is shown here. In this case, using gate itself, you can switch on and switch off both. For switching on, you have to give a gate pulse. For switching off, again you have to give a special type of gate pulse. Then only it becomes off. But mostly, these are used. Here gate circuit is very complicated. Then MOSFET are designed for low voltage. Thyristor available for high voltage, high current also. Now MOSFET cannot take very high surge current. Thyristor can take very high surge current. For example, I have shown you one thyristor TYN616. Normal current is 16 ampere. For surge current, it can take 190 ampere for 10 milliseconds. Non-repetitive. Means, if you flow current for 10 milliseconds this much, 190 ampere, then again you cannot keep current. You have to wait till it cools down. So it is called non-repetitive surge current. MOSFET application used for fast switching in DC circuits. Thyristor used in AC line frequency, 50 Hz, or in some countries 60 Hz will be their load. Also used in high voltage, high current application like HVDC and SVC. Once we wanted thyristor for 100 kilovolt and 1000 ampere. But we had the thyristor of 1 kilovolt and 1000 ampere. So in one HVDC application. So we connected 96 thyristor in series to make it 100 kV. Then for MOSFET, extra diode is required to protect from reverse voltage. It cannot take reverse voltage. You have to connect a diode like this. But this can take reverse voltage, can take full reverse voltage. So no diode is required like this. Now here we will see on-off function of MOSFET and thyristor. These two are thyristor, this is MOSFET. In MOSFET, we have connected one DC and one resistor. When we give a gate pulse, this becomes on. And when this is on, current flow in this. So this is off period, this is on period from here to here till gate pulse is there. As soon as gate pulse is removed, this becomes off. So this is off period. Here case is different. Here we give AC. This voltage is shown here one cycle. Like here we also give gate pulse for short duration. When pulse was not there, this was off. The full voltage will come here because it is off. So this voltage and this voltage is same. At this point, when you give gate pulse, thyristor become on. As soon as thyristor becomes on, current will flow. So current starts flowing. At this point, here voltage again becomes zero and start becoming negative. So this current also becomes zero, and when current becomes zero here, this thyristor becomes off. So again full voltage comes. So in this case, this is off period, this is on period. After this pulse also it remains on till current becomes zero. When current becomes zero, it becomes off. Here, we have connected one reactor or inductor. This is this. This is V thyristor voltage across this. And this is current flowing in this. Here also when we give a gate pulse like the here, this thyristor will come on. As soon as it becomes on, current will flow. So IL is this current. At this point, current starts flowing. When this voltage becomes zero, this current does not become zero. It will continue to flow. Reactor is like that. Now voltage becomes negative. This thyristor is still on because current has not become zero. Now when voltage becomes negative here, this current will start reducing. Energy stored here will be transferred to this incomer. When this IL becomes zero here, then only thyristor becomes off. So it has become off again, full voltage comes. In this case, from here to here it was on. But because of reactor, from here to here it is on. I have shown for explanation that this thyristor is being triggered at this point. But in actual use, this pulse goes only after 90 degrees, such that this current doesn't flow for such a long duration. Here I have assembled two circuits. This one is this. This one is this. They are similar. Only difference is, here I have used MOSFET, here I have used thyristor. This is load resistance. When we close the switch, voltage will come here and MOSFET will become on. And as soon as voltage comes here, this green LED also will glow. This will show that gate pulse is going. Green LED means gate pulse is on to this MOSFET. Similarly, this LED is also for indication red color. When MOSFET is on, LED current flow like this, load current will flow like this, LED current will flow like this, and this LED will glow. So this will indicate gate pulse is going, this will indicate MOSFET is on. This resistor and this resistor are connected at gate such that the gates are not floating. Now at present, we are here, switch is open, both LED are off. Now this switch is this, I will press this. See, this LED indicate green that gate pulse is going. This indicate that this has become on. And we are here now. Gate pulse has come and MOSFET has become on. Now I will open this switch. So this gate pulse will go. This LED will become off. This also should become off. See, both are off. So now we are here. Gate pulse has been removed. So this MOSFET has become off. Now we come here. Here also similar. This green LED is for gate pulse indication. And this red LED will indicate that thyristor is on. When thyristor is on, the load current will flow like this. And this is gate pulse, this thyristor becoming on. Now I will close this switch. So this green LED is glowing, means gate pulse is going. Now gate current is flowing like this. Here there was no gate current, only voltage will come here. With voltage itself it will come on. Here, voltage will come here and current also will flow like this. And load current is flowing, this thyristor is on and this LED also is glowing. Now we will open this switch. See, this remains on. Now switch is open, so no gate pulse is going. But we have discussed already, by removing gate pulse, this thyristor will not become off. So we have removed the gate pulse, but thyristor is still on. To make it off, we have to make this current zero. This can be made zero by opening this power supply. So I will open power supply, so the thyristor will come off. See, it has become off. I will show once more. Now we are here. Now both are glowing, we are here. Gate pulse also, thyristor also is on. Now to come here, gate pulse has become zero. I open the switch, but thyristor is still on. By opening this, thyristor will come off. And now it will, I have connected power supply again. But thyristor is not becoming on, because you have to give gate pulse again. Today, this much only.